How to get started in artificial intelligence. Introducing the Thumbtack Framework. First, I'll lay out many disciplines that'll help you with artificial intelligence. Next, I'll introduce the Thumbtack Framework, which will help you combine many of these disciplines to position yourself in a unique way that'll be valuable to your organization. Many people ask me how to get started in AI. My answer is that depends on what you want to do. Not everyone's goals are the same, nor is everyone's journey. So I don't want to tell you exactly what path to take. Instead, I'll take a different approach and create a framework that'll help you become an expert in AI, no matter what your focus is. Since this is a framework, you can adapt it to your own needs. There are two major branches of artificial intelligence. Symbolic AI uses symbols and shapes to represent information in computers. Statistical AI uses numbers to represent information in computers. Machine learning is the major discipline here. Deep learning is a further subset of machine learning that essentially uses artificial neural networks to solve problems. Nowadays, there is a lot of focus on data-based AI. So I'll dive deeper into this topic that'll help you build large-scale machine learning systems. Business process optimization and management. After all, most AI will be implemented as part of a business process to make it more intelligent. Business architecture. That'll help you understand how the different pieces of the business fit together. It's good to know where you want to prioritize your AI implementations, for example. Domain knowledge, such as in finance, insurance, or health, or manufacturing, or agriculture. AI often has to be adapted for specific domains. Creative and innovative thinking to reframe problems differently. In many cases, AI will help you solve the same problem in innovative ways. Communication and storytelling through data will help you convince the right people to lean on your recommendations. Visualization is important to present complex ideas in an understandable and actionable way to your business colleagues. Metrics and analytics is used to measure the right business value and outcomes. As businesses transform, business metrics will help you understand how well the business is doing. Big data to source, manage, process, and govern large volumes of data that is increasing every day. Data is critical to building machine learning systems. Technology architecture will help you understand how the systems work together to enable the business. Data structures will help you represent data in different ways that make it easier to manage, understand, and derive value from. Algorithms that help you construct step-by-step processes and introduce you to think in a structured way. It'll also teach you about computational measures because even the world's fastest computers cannot solve certain kinds of data problems in a reasonable amount of time. Programming languages like C, Python, and R, and others will help you instruct computers on what they should be doing. Python is by far the most commonly used language for machine learning. Object-oriented programming concepts helps you build large-scale systems in a modular fashion while hiding some of the complexity. Principles of software engineering, including DevOps, will help you build and deploy large-scale enterprise-class systems at regular intervals. MLOps is a variation of DevOps focused on machine learning. This discipline will help you maintain, monitor, and deploy end-to-end machine learning systems so it can be kept up to date as business conditions change. Linear algebra. This will teach you about representing and manipulating data in multidimensional spaces. This is foundational to understanding machine learning. Calculus and partial differential equations will help you create complex neural networks and reduce error functions. Optimization theory will help you create better machine learning models and optimize business processes. Hardware concepts such as TPUs or tensor processing units, GPUs or graphical processing units, and CPUs or computing processing units on which machine learning models run is important. Sensor technology to gather data such as from IoT devices or wearables. As you can tell, there are many disciplines in the universe of possibilities, and I have covered only a fraction. One person cannot be an expert in all these disciplines. It's the combination of skills that create these limitless possibilities, which is great news for you and me. If you leverage your experience and consider what you might be interested in the future, you can put these together to position yourself uniquely. The more areas you know, the better will your positioning be. But you also have to have depth in some areas. Which brings me to my thumbtack framework. A thumbtack has a large head which tapers towards a pin. Both the head and the pin are necessary for it to do its job. Just like the head of a thumbtack, each of us have studied and mastered many disciplines. The more topics you know, the better you are as your overall understanding of the world. Even though we know a lot, we use specific skills and backgrounds to define our current expertise. That expertise or focus is your identity and defines your brand. This is precisely the pin. Sometimes there is a sequence to learning advanced topics. For example, trying to learn programming without understanding data structures is difficult. Likewise, it's not easy to get good at machine learning without knowing linear algebra. What is your thumbtack in the AI space? In my case, even though I have experience with many of these disciplines, the one common thread that binds it all together for me is knowledge representation. As I studied many disciplines, I picked up how different techniques of modeling are used to represent knowledge. For example, software is being modeled, data is modeled, machine learning is obviously modeled, business processes are modeled, business is modeled, and the list goes on and on. The better I understand how disciplines model knowledge, the better I'm able to model knowledge in machines as well as my own mind, so I can communicate it effectively. Artificial intelligence is essentially the study of how machines represent, understand, and interpret knowledge about its external world. For example, this relational diagram shows how two pieces of data are related. This simple visual represents approximately how an object can be placed on a table. Modeling is often a representation of the reality we want to understand. So my pin is modeling and storytelling. What about you? What's your own interest, background, and what are your goals? What personal brand would you like to develop in the future? You can add more disciplines to this framework because you might have interest in things that I haven't even covered here. You can organize these disciplines in many ways, one being foundational, general, and specialized. You can begin to visualize, understand relationship between the disciplines so that you can be smart about your learning journey. For example, if you're a manager of a large international company, you might not want to write machine learning code, but you could build skills in managing large-scale transformational projects. This calls for skills such as project management, strategy formulation, and execution experience and skills. If you're a domain expert, you might work with machine learning engineers and management to implement process changes within your domain. This calls for domain knowledge, collaboration skills with technologists, and the ability to design great customer experiences. There are a lot of ways to position yourself using this framework to define your own pin or your brand. Give it some thought and get back to me with what your framework and your positioning might look like. A few principles make this framework very effective. Be curious about other disciplines and continue to learn and grow. This framework provides the building blocks where you can continue to improve your professional positioning in AI over time. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. If you would like a one-page visual summary of this video, please sign up on my website. Thank you deeply for giving me the motivation to do what I do.